art is life for me. Just everything right now is what I breathe, like every day. And like it's my way of existence. I don't know if that makes sense. Like I live a trail of art. Like my existence most likely will be measured by my art and what I'm creating. And when I'm no more, my art just speaks to the living when I'm dead.
Well, leaving Nigeria is one of the biggest sacrifices I've ever made in my life. Because I got to a point in my life where I just knew that I couldn't combine my 9-to-5 work as a lawyer and as an artist, because I would go to work 9-to-5 and then 5 to following morning. I'll be in my gallery, my studio, just doing art with friends. And art is not something that people, like family or anybody, sees as like something to do, you know, like a way of life, you know. And it hurt me so much because I was so passionate, but nobody understood my passions, like I was crazy. So, because I gave a lot of hours doing art, but nobody, like immediate family, they don't really recognize or say, oh man, you did a great job. It's more like, why are you, my dad used to say, why are you minoring in your major and you're majoring in your minor, which is something that it was so devastating. Every time it devastated me, because I'm like, I always replied in my mind, because you can't talk to your father, like, who are you to tell me what my major is and what my minor is? Because I know what my major is, and that's what I'm exactly what I'm doing, but you don't know. So you think, you know, this is what I'm supposed to do. So it was a lot of like fights, you know, from not wanting to go to law school, to not wanting to even study law at all in the first place. And I told my dad I was going to be an artist. I remember that night in the lawyer, he drove me around the city in his car, and he was showing me different, you know, artists, you know, very poor ones, you know, all the trees and paintings, and driving around like, look at that artist, and oh, look at that other artist, and it messed my mind a lot. Like, that was when I was fucked. I was like, no, I'm not doing art, so I chose law. Of course, halfway into it, I was like, nah, this is not for me, because I struggled a lot, you know? Like every other kid, you know, everybody has stories in class, like, ah, you know, I wanted to be, you know, I wanted to go to, you know, I wanted to be a writer, you know, I wanted to, you know, do bakery and all shit. People had all sorts of dreams, you know, and we're all just there, like, well, we're here, you know, we got to survive, you know, it's art, so everybody's like, you know, you have to be this, you know, in this country to survive.
I called something, I just started working on a series called Sacred Art of the Ori. It's like, it's something I coined. The sacred Ori in Yoruba is essence. It's your entirety. Yorubas would say the Ori itself is a shortening of an Orisha onto itself. So Yorubas have a saying, they would say, Orila Babo, which technically means you as a human, you are an Orisha, and you can worship yourself. Self-love, self-worth, dignity, everything. It's bigger than that. The fact that the Olodumare, the God of Yoruba people's God, the entirety, actually sees every human as having their own Ori and their own Orisha. And that before you were ever born, there's a life you have already taken, and there's a destiny of yours you're supposed to fulfill on earth. So every human is supposed to find that destiny. And it's crazy, because I've been painting all my life, and I've painted on all sorts of surfaces, but when I moved to human body, it's just like, it was like, damn shit, that's crazy, how did you do it? You know, people think I use all sorts of things, and people send me all sorts of God emails, people think I put things in my pen, people ask me what kind of ritual form do I have to sacrifice something for it? Like, you know, people ask me all sorts of things. And people, for the part, people even think I'm a makeup artist or a body. I'm like, no, I'm an artist. Like, I paint on anything. So if you see my mantra, is like, everything is my canvas. Like, I'm not restricted to anything. I paint on clothes, I paint on bodies, I paint on canvas, I paint on walls, I've done murals, and And it's just amazing that I'm finding myself right here in this city. And this city has helped me to explore. And I keep exploring and I'm meeting people. And it's like my life is just exploding and it's starting. And like, I've not even been here for long. And like, you just know some things are meant to be. Because I mean, you meet people who are ready to do anything for you because they believe in you. Which is so hard back home because you have to know somebody, you know, to know somebody to, you know, I mean, I'm not saying people don't know people, don't have to know anybody, but the thing is here, once you have something, and people see your work, you put in the work, and you know, like the hard work, and you see that you're genuine, and you're real, as a cop. People want that, and there's that connection of, I see you, I understand you, and also the reason I see them, and I understand them, and there's that connection, and when that happens, it's good, because we're all able to work, and it's amazing. I'm just happy, you can see from my lens, I'm just excited to be alive right now, like, there's a lot that's gonna happen, and trust me, this interview, it's gonna go down memory. I'm not trying to be arrogant, but I'm happy I'm doing this right now, because, yeah, I'm happy I'm doing this, and thank you.
You call a woman, African woman, no go green, she go say,